فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is lecture number 48 from the Right Belief series. This is our semester number 4, where we discuss the second article of faith, which is believe in the two worlds of the unseen, the angel and the jinn. And so far we completed 6 lectures talking about the angels, and today inshallah is our 7th lecture and the first lecture addressing the subject of the jinn and the devils and our belief regarding that world as well. So we finished talking about the world of the angels and all the details about it, and today is the world of the jinn and devils. Needless to say that recently that subject dominated the hearts and minds of a lot of Muslims. A lot of people are so consumed with the subject of sorcery, witchcraft, spells, evil eye, being possessed by jinn. It's becoming like a profession even for some Muslims. ما سمعنا, we never heard that the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started their own practices, clinics. You found now that some Muslims are actually having clinics to treat people who are possessed by jinn, and getting out sorcery from their system in a way. First of all, we do not deny the existence of these evil forces in our world. We actually believe in them, but at the same time we balance our belief that Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam advised us to certainly seek remedy. He said sallallahu alaihi wasallam كما في صحيح الإمام مسلم, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not bring down a disease, but he also brought down the cure for it. Tadawaw. And he said tadawaw, seek cure for these diseases. Now, immediately, an average Muslim, because they are so much consumed with the idea of jinn and being possessed with jinn, immediately, as soon as they become sick, the first thing that they think about, without even entertaining the medicine and the cure, they immediately say that this is because of it is a possession of jinn and because of sorcery or evil eye. Possibly, we're not dismissing the fact that it is possible, there is a chance there, but we must encourage people to certainly seek remedy and cure first before they jump the gun and conclude that what they have is caused by an evil eye or sorcery. Basically, the Muslim is puzzled between two schools. And that's really where the core of the issue is the confusion is. Those who believe in divine revelation, they end up saying every disease that you have because of sorcery, because you're possessed by jinn, because of evil eye, because of spells. So they dismiss what? The possibility of having some actually physical cause for the disease. The other end or the other extreme of this is the, we call them the modernists. Is that a good word? Modernists? Or the secularists, the people who do not believe in the world of the unseen. They simply deny that there are jinn. They don't believe that. They actually think that this is illusions and thoughts of the human being, but they have no existence, as we will discuss. So they totally dismiss the possibility of that world of the unseen and the fact that they can influence, they can affect the human life with harm. So they totally dismiss it. On the other hand, they totally say, no, it's because of sorcery. But the truth really is in the middle. The middle, the right path is in the middle. First, we seek remedy. Then if there is no cure for it, sometimes people come to me and say, I done all type of scans, all type of x-rays. The doctor telling me that I don't have a problem physically. Then I tell him, then you need a ruqya, you need to do ruqya. Possibly it's an evil eye. We believe in the evil eye. وَمِن شَرِّ هَذَا فِي الْقُرْآنِ. Anybody who denies that is belying the Qur'an. وَمِن شَرِّ حَاسِدٍ إِذَا حَسَدٍ. And we believe in the power of sorcery, that people can do spell on you, seeking the assistance and the help of the jinn to harm you. And a lot of us sometimes we look into hadith sihr al-Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because when we say this, when we speak about this, a lot of the people, they think that they are far away from it. Don't assume that. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam for a wisdom, and one of these wisdoms that you're not immune from this. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself, a Jew in Medina, did some spells on him. Again, he's a human being like you and me, so don't live with the idea that you're immune from that. Now, and inshallah, I understand that you're here for this subject of possession by jinn, and in no way, I just want to disclaim that I'm not here to teach you how to do that, how to take out a jinni from the body of somebody. I'm not planning to do that, if this is why you're here. But we want to study the subject academically, using the evidence from the Quran and the Sunnah, and try to understand it. So we're going to address the subject. But before I go there, I want to let you know something, because somehow a lot of Muslims are magnifying the power of jinn and Satan as if it's a power that you cannot defeat. And this is untrue. This is untrue. You can defeat Satan. You can defeat the evil jinni. You can do it. But what it takes? A heart that is filled with tawheed, reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sincerity, a heart that is not heedless, that you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, that you're not weak. I'm saying that you fall permanently under the influence of your desires. I'm not saying that sometimes we fall short, we make mistakes, but you don't become totally captive to your whims and desires. You can defeat Satan. And I will share with you a story, and all of this, by the way, is an introduction. Ibn al-Jawzi mentioned that story in his book, Al-Hasan al-Basri is the one who narrated it. Whether it is true or not, we don't know. We don't have a chain of narration to it. I'm not saying that this is something which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. But in a way, that story shows you that. Here is what the story reads. That somebody was living in a village or in a town. And by all of a sudden, the people in this town started worshipping a tree. A certain tree. They said that tree is God. And they started to actually go and worship that tree and prostrate to the tree, do tawaf around it, offer sacrifice to it. So, man ra'a minkum, whoever sees evil, let him what? Change it. So this believer in this town decided to change that. This is haram. This is shirk. This is polytheism, and we're going to have to do something about this. So he said the ideal way in order to avoid any conflicts with the people, he decided while they are asleep at night, he's going to take an axe. I always mess those two. Okay, he decided to take an axe and go, and he's going to take that tree down. Guess who met him in the way? Shaitan in a form of a man. Where are you going? I'm going to cut that tree. No, you're not. Yes, I am going. No, you're not. Yes, I am. No, you're not. Yes, I am. No, you're not. Come on. It's supposed to be funny. Yes, I am. It's supposed to be funny here. So they got in a fist fight. That believer beat the heck out of this man. If this is good English, I don't know. The heck, I don't know, they say that. That is the way of Shaitan. When he doesn't get you this way, he comes around. He's smart. He plans. He said, can I tell you something? He said, can I tell you something? You're a righteous, pious man. Those people are already wicked. They are going to hell. I have a good idea for you. You know what? You go home and you don't have to work anymore. And every single day, I'm going to drop for you 2 dinars in the morning. So you end up staying in your house, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you don't have to go to work. Those people are already doomed because they are already in shirk. Why do you bother? You should dedicate more time to Allah. And when you go to work, you waste that time, I'll help you. The man, that makes sense. You see, that's why a learned person would not buy that, by the way. A learned person is stronger on shaitan than 1,000 worshipper. Somebody who just worships, he doesn't have the knowledge, shaitan can get to him easy, can play with him. But someone who has the knowledge, he will not buy that. Because we say what? Al-amal, al-amal is an act of worship if you have the right intention. When you work, you're actually worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you're providing for your family. It's an act of worship. But he sold it to him. Shaitan sold it to him. He bought it. So he went back home. The first day, he found the 2 dinars in the morning. The second day, he found the 2 dinars. The third day, no 2 dinars, no money. What's wrong now with those people? What is the problem? Why did he break his promise? Ma shaitana. Okay, tonight I'm taking the axe and I'm going to cut that tree. So he took his axe at night to cut the tree. Guess who met him? Shaitan. Where are you going? I'm going to cut that tree. It's haram. polytheist. Say, no, you're not. Yes, I am. No, you're not. Yes, I am. No, you're not. There you go. So they got in a fight. Guess what? Shaitan beat the heck out of him. Shaitan beat him so bad. So the man got so puzzled. And he asked, how come the first time I beat you and the second time you defeated me? He said, the first time you were fighting for Allah, the second time you were fighting for the 2 dinars. See that? So you can defeat shaitan if you establish servitude to Allah. If you establish servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah declared this at the very beginning. He said to shaitan, "Inna ibadi laysa laka alayhim sultan." Inna ibadi laysa laka alayhim sultan. My servant, those who become my ibad, my slaves, those who worship me, those who obey me, you will have no power whatsoever over them. A lot of us stop here, but we don't pay attention to the tail of the verse. What is the tail of that verse? Anyone knows? وَكَفَى بِرَبِّكَ وَكِيلًا. What does it mean? Shaitan is going to blot. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not make his blood work on you. Satan is still going to try to harm you. But any act that is done needs Allah's approval. Allah's decree for it to fall upon you. Allah will not enable your act to harm the believers. Again, the concept that I'm trying to say here, that we're becoming like jinn, it's jinni, it's yummy, jinn, even our kids. La, we gotta build up. It's because our hearts are empty. Our hearts are not filled with tawheed, with iman, with faith. That is why we have that overwhelming fear that is growing and developing, and we're passing it on to the next generation. Very unfortunate. Very quickly, in the introduction, all of this is an introduction. A lot of the people may think or may claim that, why do we need to study this stuff? Why are you going to teach us the jinn, and what is the importance of this? First of all, I want to say something. Because a lot of the people claim that this is unnecessary knowledge. See what some countries, especially the United States, how much they spend of their resources to discover what's in the moon. You know how much is the budget for NASA and these projects? Enough to feed the hungry people in the face of this earth. To discover what? That's not even in our planet. Now, you shouldn't pay attention to a creation that lives with us in the same earth. They influence our thought. They whisper into our hearts. If we allow them, they eat with us. If we allow them, they sleep with us. If we allow them, they have a relationship with the spouse, with you, if you allow them. You shouldn't know about them? There's something wrong here. Add to this, quickly, in الإنسان جبل على حب الغيب. Somehow Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed inside us the love of the unseen. The love to discover the things that are beyond our senses. You want to know it. You want to learn about it. That's why, why in the world do you go to a fortune teller? A woman like this holds your hands and tells you you have two roads. One of them is good and one of them is bad. Everybody has two roads. You have to, I mean, the coffee cup, some cultures, huh? Misr? شمعنا مصري عم تما في الشام ده ها في الشام برضه What about this, the fortune cookies? Huh? You tell me you go to Chinese restaurant because it's cheap food, but you go there because of the fortune cookies. And you read it and you believe it. I came across, not you of course, you wouldn't be here, I'm just talking to other people. I mean, I came across some people who would not go out of their homes in the morning without reading the horoscopes in the paper. The horoscopes, you're going to have an accident today. Okay, I'm not going out. That is all what? Now what we're going to study is based on evidence. Because that unseen has to be made available to you by divine. Because it's not subject to experiment, that you experiment and then تجارب يعني, and then you figure it out. Nah, unseen, no experiment. Actually, the scholars say also, no qiyas in issues of unseen. No analogy. You cannot use analogy in issues of unseen. You cannot produce facts from existing facts. You can't even do that. We must learn about this subject and give it time. Add to this, ya ikhwa, imagine the amount of the text in the Quran and the Sunnah talking about jinn and shaitan. You know how much texts are there? Wealth of text. Priceless. Beyond any value. Very valuable. The text that we have in the Quran and the Sunnah. So let's discover this world. Inshallah, here is the plan that I have for you. Like I said, I'm not here to teach you how to take a jinni out. I'm not here to teach you how to do sihr or spills. We're students of knowledge and we want to discuss this subject as students of knowledge. And here is what we're going to try to cover, inshallah, quickly. First of all, we want to define and describe this world briefly. Their origin, the origin of the jinn, their creation, their names, their types, their food, their drink, their marriages, their dwelling places, their riding beasts. They do have riding beasts. They ride beasts. And their abilities. What can they do? And also the things which they cannot do. Don't assume that they can do anything. No. Jinn are unable to do certain things. We're going to discover this. Then, inshallah, we're going to talk about the purpose, why they were created. Why the jinn were created. Huh? وَمَا خَلَقْتُ. So they were created to do what? To worship, like us. Oh. And the way that they received the message. Do they have their own messengers from the jinn? Or the message that is sent to the human suffices them? We know for a fact once it came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he is a messenger to the jinn and to the human. We believe that. And we have evidence in the Quran and in the Sunnah to establish that belief. Then we're going to talk about why shaitan hates us. And this is the core of the subject here of our lectures. The reasons shaitan has animosity against the human race. and the long and short-term goals of shaitan when he deals with us. He has long and short-term. If he doesn't get you this way, he gets you that way. And he plans ahead. Yani, a thought that occurred to me today when I was at Overland, Overland Park or Overland? Just Overland? High school. It's amazing. The students there are so... Is that in the curriculum or what? They kept asking me these questions about the jinn, about the angels. It's like, you guys need to come to the class at night. They are so interested in that subject, just to let you know that subhanAllah, this subject can create a lot of ground for da'wah. But something that occurred to me, the thought that occurred to me, how shaitan, Satan, plan long term. You know the hadith which I narrate to you all the time, that every single morning, hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhuma and the Muslim, shaitan sets his throne on water. You know that hadith, right? And he basically gives incentives to his helpers from the jinni. Whoever does the best job today in misguiding Muslims, I will place the crown with my own hands on your head. Disperse. Then the jinn would disperse to do their mischief. They come in the evening reporting their accomplishment for the day. One of them, the devils, they will say, well, today, Mr. Shaitan, today I was able to whisper to those two Muslims. I whispered to his heart, I got them fighting, and one of them killed the other. Good job. Nice peace. Sit down. The other one, he says, you know, this person always, you know, admired those people who get wasted and get high. He always looks at them like these guys must have a fun life. So I kept whispering to him until he bought some entertainment marijuana from the shop, and he took a buff. He got high. Because in Colorado, you know, they made it loof. Well, he could say that. Isn't that crazy? Wallah, I was out of town this weekend and I heard about it from... What the people are telling me, what are you doing in that state? They made marijuana legal. Aren't you afraid that you're going to be smoking weed one of these days? I'm the imam, I'm not going to do that. I thought it was just medical. Now it's entertainment marijuana? This is absurd, man. I don't know what's going on with this state. Now you can actually take marijuana for entertainment. Wonderful. This jinni will stand up and say, today I was able to separate a husband and a wife. You know what shaitan will say? Ni'ma ant. Anta ant. You are my man. Come out. And crowns him. هذا حديث صحيح يا اخو في صحيح مسلم حديث صحيح مسلم حديث جابر. Reflect upon this. Smoking weed is haram. Killing is haram. Adultery is haram. Name any sin you want. Divorce is not haram. Divorce is not haram. هذا الحديث أبغض الحلال عند الله الطلاق ضعيف لا ينسب للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. حديث ضعيف. No, don't attribute it to the Prophet. The most hated halal in the sight of Allah is divorce. Is not correct. You can divorce al-mar'a al-sawwama al-qawwama, and there is no problem as long as you give her what? I'm not asking you to do this, but as long as you give her rights, khalas. It's a contract. Marriage is a contract. Obligations upon you, obligations upon her. You fulfill that, you're free. Now, why is he so excited Why is so happy? He's so happy about divorce. Why? That's the thought that happened to me today while I was talking to these kids. You know, I always hear that that your enemy always likes to do what? Divide and? You know that concept? That divide and conquer. Divide and conquer. Now he is able to divide the first unit in the community. Because look at your community. The community is made of what? Units. Imagine a wall, bricks. The family is the first brick in the community. So he was able to divide where? To strike where? The first unit. Becomes then easy to divide the community, divide a congregation. His job is made. That's why he's what? He has long-term plans. We're going to talk about his ways of misguiding Muslims and the tricks that he plans for you. And inshallah, we're going to give special attention to the issue of being possessed by jinn and what is going on, and we're going to discuss it, we're going to talk about it, and the wrong things which the people do now, and the fact that it's turning into a job for some people, and the people attributing, like I said at the very beginning of the lecture, everything that they suffer from to the jinn. And then we're going to talk about the weapons which a believer can have in his battle and fight against the jinn. And inshallah, we're going to conclude our study with the wisdom why. What is the wisdom Allah, or the wisdom why Allah created shaitan? A lot of us ask that question. What is the wisdom? So are you ready? All of this is an introduction, by the way. I don't know if you're aware.
I have two questions.
No questions at the end, inshallah. We're going to open the floor for, just write them down right now. Well, if we go there, you know, with questions, I get sidetracked. Okay. So let me see here. How long can we go today? I don't want to force it on you. 8 o'clock is fair? Assalamu alaikum. Is fair? 8 is fair? I'm not sure if I can go until 8:30, but we'll go until 8, inshallah. I was actually going to suggest to you, I don't know if you want, it's up to you, if we can do Friday and Saturday and Sunday this week. Okay, what about Saturday, inshallah? Can we do Saturday this week? You're okay with that? Saturday, yeah, both, Saturday and Sunday. It's up to you. Maghrib, Isha? Okay. After Isha or Maghrib Isha? Come on, make up your mind. We can go after Isha if we need to extend it. So Saturday, Sunday, Maghrib Isha, inshallah. No, we're going to do Wednesdays, but we're just going to add one more day for the days that we missed. Okay. Saturday between Maghrib and Isha. And Sunday between Maghrib and Isha, inshallah. Good? So we have those 2 days to make up for one of these days which you missed. Okay, the definition of the world of the jinn and the devils. The jinn is a world other than the world of the human race, and also different to the world of the angels. They do have some common things with the mankind in the sense of they possess the ability to choose. So just look at these three races. Angels have the ability to choose or not, yes or no? Jinn have the ability to choose or not?
Yes.
Mankind has the ability to choose or not?
Yes.
What angels and jinn have in common in relation to us? They are not seen. Unseen, they are unseen unless they do what? They take a different form than their actual form, original form. We got that? Why they were called jinn? It's very interesting linguistically. You know that the word jannah? Jannah. Al-majan, al-janin. Those three. Jannah, al-majan. Al-majan means the shield. Wal-janin. Al-janin is the fetus. Why the janin is called janin? Because it's where? It's in the womb, you don't see it. Al-majan is the shield that you place at the time of war. Why it's called that? Because it does what? It conceals what? It conceals, yani it does protect, but the word that we need here is a conceal something behind it. Jannah is also derived from there. Why? Jannah, when you have trees and the branches of these trees, what they end up doing? They connect together and they block you from seeing it, or blocking the sun from coming through, and that's why the word Jannah comes there. So, summa, they were called jinn, lijtinanihim, wastitarihim, anil uyun, because they are concealed, they are unseen from the human senses. Qala ibn Aqil, innama, ibn Aqil says, innama summiya al-jinnu jinnan, لاجتنانهم واستتارهم عن العيون ومنه الجنين والمجن والجنة. And this was mentioned in the Quran. إنه يراكم هو وقبيله من حيث لا ترونهم. Verily he, meaning Satan, and his soldiers from the jinn, see you from where you cannot see them. Their origin of creation, the Quran spoke about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالْجَانَّ خَلَقْنَاهُ مِنْ قَبْلُ مِنْ نَارِ السَّمُومِ. And the jinn were created before that, meaning before man, from the flameless fire. From the smokeless flame of fire. So, nar samum, smokeless flame of fire. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Rahman, وَخَلَقَ الْجَانَّ مِنْ مَارِجٍ مِنْ نَارٍ. Ibn Abbas says in explaining that verse, وَعِكْرِمَةَ وَمُجَاهِدْ وَالْحَسَنْ مَارِجٌ مِنْ نَارٍ, means the edge of the flame, the purest and the best, and the best part of the flame, the purest and the best part of the flame. Al-Imam al-Nawawi says in explaining Sahih al-Imam Muslim, Al-Marij al-Lahab al-Mukhtalitu bi-Sawad al-Nar. He said, Al-Marij, the flame which is mixed with the blackness of the fire. Kalam kullu yaltaqi, created from fire. Wa'anna hadith Aisha radiallahu anha, the hadith that we shared with you in Sahih al-Imam Muslim, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, خلقت الملائكة من نور. The angels were created from light. وخلق الجان من مارج من نار. And the jinn were created from a smokeless flame of fire. وخلق آدم مما وصف لكم. And Adam was created from what was described to you in the Quran. Clay, water, dirt, all of the above. When were they created? For sure, they were created before the human being. No question, because of the verse. وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ مِنْ صَلْصَالٍ مِنْ حَمَإٍ مَسْنُونَ This is in Surah Al-Hijr. وَالْجَانَّ خَلَقْنَاهُ مِنْ قَبْلٍ So they were created before Adam عليه السلام. يا إخوة, again the story of creation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created everything in 6 days. Adam was the last of Allah's creation. Adam was created on last day, which is Friday, after Asr. A lot of the scholars, ومنهم ابن عمر, early scholars, but we don't have an evidence establishes this. They say that the jinn were created 2,000 years, meaning 2 days, before Adam. And they were also placed in earth. They shed blood, they corrupted earth, they did all type of evil. That is why, or the wisdom why, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed the angels of creating another creation that has the freedom to choose, الخلافة, خليفة meaning the freedom to choose, the angel said what? How did they object? I'm sorry, that's the wrong word. How did they comment on this? What did they say? أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءِ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ Are you going to place therein another creation? Because you see, they used analogy. They used qiyas. If that race is like the jinn, meaning they have the freedom of choice, they're going to do what? They're going to shed blood. They're going to do exactly like the jinn. Now we don't have the freedom of choice. We should be there. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them, إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ Again, there is a scholarly, opinion, which was not established in the sunnah, that they were created 2,000 years, before Adam alayhi as-salam. طيب, how the jinn were created? We don't know. We don't know how they were created. The only thing that we know that they were created from what? The smokeless flame of fire. And we stop at that. We don't say how. But we know from the Quran and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that they do have faculties, like senses. Senses. وَلَقَدْ ذَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ Look at this. لَهُمْ قُلُوب So they do have hearts. لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُن So they do have eyes. لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ آذَان They do have ears. لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا لأن أصل الآية ولقد ذرأنا لجهنم كثيرا من الجن والإنس both so they do have senses so they do have eyes ears but does it look like us I don't know but they listen with ears they do have voices Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to shaitan واستفزز من استطعت منهم بصوتك and befool them gradually with your voice. Some of the scholars say it's the music, but Allah said صوتك, your voice. Allah knows best. They do have actually tongues. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he hold that jinni, he hold it from his tongue. They eat, they drink. They laugh and other things we'll discover. Are we doing okay so far? Huh? إذا كان هم اللي اخترعوا الكحول يا طيب The various types of jinn and their names. What are the types of jinn and their names? يقول ابن عبد البر رحمه الله, one of the early scholars, he says, الجن عند أهل الكلام على مراتب. There are different types of jinn. Number one, if you use the word jinn, then you mean all of them. See, jinni, that means what? Everybody. That is one. But if you mean those who dwell with the human beings, they call them عامر, a dweller. And the plural is عمار, dwellers, those who live in the houses with you. Remember, when you enter the house, if you don't say Bismillah, what happens? The jinn says what? I have a place to sleep tonight. And probably he sleep, everybody, just tell me, I'm telling you, only few Muslims would remember Bismillah at the entry. Jinn is filling the homes. They actually have beds there and just, like, I mean, the jinn now is accompanying us to the homes like, you're not going to say Bismillah, man, I don't know you. I'm going to get my sleep tonight. I mean, sometimes, you know, subhanAllah, when we eat, you know, say, you forget. But you should say, if you forget what? Bismillah fi awwalihi wa akhiri. You should do that. So he stops eating. طيب. There is that type that bother the children. There is one type, by the way, and that's why, brothers and sisters in Islam, make sure that you recite Ruqya on your children. There is actually a certain type which are called spirits, which actually bother the children. Get to the children. They are called spirits. They call them souls. They basically bother the children. What do they call? Souls. Spirits. Yani, somehow they, what I think how Satan organizes this, I'm assuming that these are kids. Let's give the low quality, to with the children. But that's why, you know, we always say, you know, a lot of the people sometimes they praise the imams and the sheikh. Oh, you're a sheikh, you're a imam. I say, my shaitan is big, man. My shaitan is so big, you know. Shaitan, I'm sure Satan designated a very, you know, big shaitan to me. So don't. So Satan, I'm sure he assesses. So kids, little kids, he's going to give them somewhat. And that, you know, when you end up with a team, and you put some on the sop, and I mean, the guy is organized. I mean, every single day he sits on his throne and he plans his day out, and he does this every day. Imagine this. He's devoted to the job. I mean, the guy is dedicated. Every day he's thrown in water, and at night he's thrown in water again. Who does this from the human being? And he receives the report, and he sits and he listens to his devils. And the guy is organized. He has a mission. He's devoted to his mission. Yahi, if we get devoted like him and his soldiers to Allah, we're going to make a difference. Say? It is a punishment, but look out. Okay. Now, so jinni in general, dwellers, could be Muslims, by the way. The dwellers in your home could be Muslim too, because like we said earlier, al-jinn, some of them are what? So you could have some Muslim jinn living in what? In your home. And we're going to establish this for you. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but again, I want to go into details with this because I don't want you to think. He actually said that if you see a female snake, it's called hayya. A female snake in your house, don't kill it. Because that could be a Muslim jinni. We're going to come to this. I don't want to go into this. There is a lot of stuff. I want to tell you, a lot of stuff. But actually, there is a very interesting story. But I just want to use this as an evidence quickly behind that Muslim jinni can be what? in your home. Not necessarily every genie in your house is what? Is a bad one. Could be a Muslim. But I'll come to that. Don't look at me like we're going to come to this. All right. But now, when they become evil, when the jinn are evil, they are called shaitan. So the shaitan is what? The devil from the jinn. You're getting that? So now the big shaitan, we know him, but any jinni who becomes evil, we call him what? That means he's not good. طيب, if his evil is elevated, also they have standards. They have levels, A1, A. They call him Marid, rebellious, defiant demons. Marid, the rebellious, defiant demons. Now, if they are top of the line, in evil, of course, they are called Ifrit, Afarit. So you got that? Jinni, in general, some of them dwell in the homes. We call them Ummar. Some of them mess up with the children. Those are easygoing. But now, when he turns into evil, we call him Shaitan. If his evil is elevated, we call him Marid, a demon, defiant demon, rebellious. If he's very strong in his evil, we call him what? Ifrit. You read the story of Sulaiman? قال عفريت من الجن أنا آتيك به قبل أن تقوم من مقامك. Imagine this. Ifrit. You know, imagine he's going to bring the throne of the queen of Sheba from Yemen to Jerusalem in 1 hour. That's what the scholars say. By the time Prophet Sulaiman finishes his gathering, in 1 hour. That is their types. We have hadith في معجم الطبراني ومستدرك الحاكم والبيهقي صححه الشيخ ناصر رحمه الله. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إن الجن ثلاثة أصناف. إن الجن ثلاثة أصناف. There are three types of jinn. صنف يطير في الهواء. One type that flies in the air. وصنف حيات وكلاب. And one type takes the shape and form of snakes and dogs. وصنف يحلون ويضعنون. And one type that moves from one place to another. They could dwell in your house for a while and they go somewhere else, they transfer themselves. We're doing okay? It's going to get more interesting, I'm telling you. Just hang in there. The other one in earth, like they travel in earth, but the other one in the air. They fly in the air, and those who يستدقون السم, those who go up there and try to spy, when I'm going to come to this once we talk about their abilities, they try to spy on the angels, try to get some information from up there. طيب, there are some people who deny the existence of jinn. أنكرت قلة من الناس وجود الجن. And those are the people who are really not believing in divine. You bring to them text from the Quran and Sunnah, they don't believe in it. They are called the rational. The people who worship their intellect, basically. They become slaves to their intellect. And they leave no place whatsoever for divine. The disbelievers, they assumed that jinn are the souls of the planets. Arwah al-kawakib. They believe the stars have power And the jinn are the souls of the stars. Because they believe in the stars. There are people who worship the stars. They believe actually the stars are what affect our world. Now the jinn are the souls inside these stars. Of course, philosophers like Aristotle and all those people, they denied the existence of the jinn, and they say the jinn are the evil inclination inside the human soul. Like the being inclined to evil, that means it's jinn. But there is no jinn, it's just the inclination. That when you think evil, that is what is jinn. But there is no something called jinn. You understand? But we believe that there are jinn and they trigger that evil inside us. Likewise, by the way, they say about this, the angels. They deny the existence of the angels. And they say the good inclination inside the human soul are the angels. The modernists, these days, they say the jinn are the microbes and the germs. They say that actually, which were discovered. So the germs and the microbes are the jinn. And some of them say that jinn are simply the angels. They are the same creation. And there is no difference between them. Notice that the ground on which they denied the existence of the jinn is not having knowledge of it. بَلْ كَذَّبُوا بِمَا لَمْ يُحِيطُوا بِعِلْمِهِ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِهِمْ تَأْوِيلُهُ. Indeed, they belied the knowledge whereof they could not comprehend. Now, what are the evidence that jinn exist? Number one, the existence of the jinn is well established in Islam and is one of the matters which is ma'lumun min ad-din bid-darura. It's known from the religion by necessity. Read Surah Al-Jinn. Enough. Read that at the end of Surah Al-Ahqaf. وَإِذْ صَرَفْنَا إِلَيْكَ نَفَرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ. Read all these texts. So it is something that is known from the religion by necessity. And anyone who denies the existence of the jinn, yakfur, disbelieves. Why? Why? لأنه, what did he do? He belied what? He belied what? If you belie one letter from the Quran, you go out of the fold of Islam. They belied the Quran. The Quran spoke of their existence. So they belied the Quran. ولذلك يقول شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية says لم يخالف أحد من طوائف المسلمين في وجود الجن. Nobody from the sects of the Muslims differed that jinn do exist. And they have consensus also that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to them Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even the Christian and the Jews, their scholars, they affirm the existence of jinn. But only few of them deny it, and those what we call the rationalist, the people of intellect. In the ulama ajma'u, the scholarly consensus during the time of the companions and the righteous predecessors, that jinn and devils do exist, and we seek refuge with Allah from their evil. The second evidence is the Quran was Sunnah. We have a lot of Quran and Sunnah. The third evidence is citing an eyewitness. We do have people who saw jinn. Even so, they cannot identify it, but you end up seeing jinn somehow in a quick. The donkey, you know what donkeys are, right? Huh? You know what the donkeys? Hug, hug, hug. Donkeys? Huh? The donkey. The dog. And one more thing. And the dogs. I didn't say. So it's What? Yeah, okay, let me say this. Donkey and dogs, they see jinn. Al-Hadith Abi Huraira, radiallahu anhu, the hadith that we quoted when we spoke about the angels, if you hear the crowing of a rooster, ask Allah for good things, because that rooster, right? Rooster. I always mess up that word with the roaster for the players. You know, you need to submit a roaster. I used to coach soccer, you know, at one stage in my life. So you used to, ref, you want to have the rooster? What rooster? You know, I used to mess up. I remember this. Can I give you, here is the rooster for my team. Rooster for my team. And it looks at me like, what this guy is talking about? It's a rooster. So the rooster, the crowing of a rooster, ask Allah for good things, because the rooster, so what? Angel. And if you hear the braying of a donkey, ask Allah, seek refuge with Allah from Satan, because he sees a shaitan. والحديث الآخر في سنن أبي داود حديث جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنهما the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says إذا سمعتم نياح الكلاب ونهيق الحمار فتعوذوا بالله فإنهم يرون ما لا ترون. If you hear the barking of a dog, the braying of a donkey, seek refuge with Allah, because they see that which you do not see. And ya ikhwa, it has been established by experiment that there are some animals who see things that we do not see. Can someone give me an example? Who? They see what? Evil? Okay. Look at this. By evidence, and the scholars, the scientists do not deny this, by the way, the scientists, the modernists, they say the bee, اللي هو النحل, is able to see the ultraviolet rays. You know what that means, right? اللي هي الأشعة فوق البنفسجية. The bee sees the sun while there is a cloud. While there is a cloud, like imagine cloud covering the horizon, the bee can see the sun. The bees. Actually, scientists do not deny this. So it's an evidence that they see things that what? And also البومة, I looked for that word, and all. You know what that means? All? Awal? Awal? It's A-W-L. Owl. Owl. An owl can see a mouse in the darkness. You see, they fly in the darkness like this, and they can, in the darkness. We have a lot of those in Egypt, this Duma thing. They actually move in the darkness, like, and they see. So it has been established. Responding to those who claim that jinn are the same like angels, very simple answer. Jinn were created from smokeless flame of fire. Angels were created from light. So the origin is what? Is different. Jinn do not, angels do not eat nor drink, nor they have a choice. But jinn eat and drink, and they do have a choice. So those are two different worlds. MashaAllah, we're doing very good. So now we introduce jinn to you. Now we want to talk about shaitan. Which is what? Shaitan is what now? The evil from the jinn. The shaitan, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to us about, belongs to the world of the angels. I'm sorry, to the world of the jinn. He's a jinni. He used to be pious and righteous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated him
to be seated with the angels. Then he developed arrogance and pride. Then he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah brought him down. You see, when you obey Allah, Allah does what? When you disobey Allah, Allah does what? That's what happened to Satan. Huwa Iblis. We're coming to this. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cast him out of his mercy. So every rebellious one, we have the main guy here, the big guy. That's the shaitan, Satan. But every rebellious, defiant demon is called shaitan. وَالشَّيْطَانُ فِي لُغَةِ الْعَرَبِ الشَّيْطَان in the Arabic language is called or is named or names any insolent, any rebellious jinni. Something that I said already. He is also called At-Taghut. At-Taghut, an Arabic word. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, I'm so entertaining. I've been talking too much about the jinni, they're out of here. I mean, I'm feeling a little bit also bummed up, I don't know why. I feel like just laughing and subhanallah, wallahi, ya akhwan. Wallahi, wallahi al-azim. Mu'adh ibn Jabal, you know, he used to say this. Wallahi, the only thing that I miss dunya for, you know, the only thing that makes me excited about the dunya is this. He actually named this, that sitting in a gathering like this. That's what I miss about this world. And also the thirst of fasting, that the feeling of the thirst because I'm fasting. Allahu musta'an. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يتقبل منا. طيب, we said shaitan, another name is what? Taghut. Why it's called taghut? First of all, the evidence. الذين آمنوا يقاتلون في سبيل الله. Those who believe, they fight in the cause of Allah. والذين كفروا يقاتلون في سبيل فقاتلوا أولياء. شايف؟ هذا اسمه بدل. And those who disbelieve, they fight in the cause of الطاغوت. فقاتلوا أولياء الشيطان. So the word شيطان replaced what? So الطاغوت is الشيطان. Why it is called that? Because he crossed his boundaries. And anyone who crosses his boundaries is called what? Why did he cross his boundaries? How come you did not bow down to Adam? Look how he answered. رَفَعَ عَقِيرَتَهُ عَلَىٰ رَبِّهِ. Imagine. You answer Allah in this man. أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِنْ. I'm better than him. And now he is calling people to his worship too. Yes. أَلَمْ أَعْهَدْ إِلَيْكُمْ يَا بَنِي آدَمَ أَلَّا. Haven't I established a covenant with you children of Adam not to worship shaitan? Innahu lakum aduwwun mubin. Oh. So he's calling people to his worship. وَلِذَلِكَ يَا إِخْوَةَ. Anything, any object, anything that is worshipped beside Allah is called what? Taghut. وَلِذَلِكَ, one of the requirements of لا إله إلا الله, you must disbelieve in what? فَمَنْ يَكْ لا إكراه في الدين قد تبين الرشد من الغي ها فمن يكفر ويؤمن فقد استمسك بالعروة الوثقى. وذلك يقول لك رؤوس يقول لك رؤوس الطواغيت. There are five طواغيت heads. شيطان, because شيطان is calling people to worship him. Two, anyone who is worshipped beside Allah while he knows and he's accepting it, that would take away who? Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Is Prophet Isa is pleased with the Christians worshipping him now? No. Three, anyone who claims the knowledge of the unseen, Anyone who claims the knowledge, anybody who claims that I know the unseen is a taghut. Why? Because people are going to end up what? Worshipping you. And there are two more. One of them is those who rule other than the Sharia. And there is one more. I forgot it. Okay. Yeah, the one who judges not using the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ahsant. The third name is Iblis. Shaitan, Taghut, Iblis. Why is he called Iblis? Al-Balasu fi al-Arabiyya. Al-Balas, the word Balas in Arabic, means to be filled with despair and confusion. Because Satan despaired from what? The mercy of Allah. وَذَاكْ سُمِّيَ Iblis. وَذَاكْ إِخْوَ دَيْرِيُ وَلَذَاكْ يقول لك two diseases that shaitan or two things that shaitan tries hard to throw at you. Number one, the first thing that he disobeyed with Allah with, which is what? Which is what? La. Arrogance. That's the second thing, he makes you despair from the mercy of Allah. He tries to do this. Allah is not going to forgive you. You did this? Oh man, you're done. You're doomed. You're doomed. He's not going to forgive you. Allah is, with that, be careful. وَلَا تَيْأَسُوا مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِنَّهُ لَا يَيْأَسُ مِنْ رَوْحِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْكَافِرُ. With that, the kafir despair from the mercy of Allah. وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَلِقَائِهِ أُولَٰئِكَ يَأِسُوا مِنْ رَحْمَتِي. For your information, a lot of the disbelievers, a lot of the disbelievers, they don't believe in Allah because they already, shaitan established in their minds and hearts that Allah is not going to have mercy on them. Because don't despair from the mercy. Allah can forgive you. That is the third name. We said shaitan. And we said what? Taghut. And we said what? Iblis. Very quickly here, we're finishing up. The origin of Satan. The only thing that we know, that Satan is from the jinn. But there are other people who disputed this. From the past and the present and the future, they will. Because of two reasons. Reason number one, being influenced by the people of the book. Because I don't know if you're aware of this or not, Christians believe that Satan is a fallen angel. Oh yeah. They actually believe that Satan is what? An opponent with Allah. Like he, a rival, fighting with Allah. Allah can wipe him. Give me a break, man. I mean, when he hears the remembrance of Allah, what does he do? قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَسِ. You know what al-khannas means? يَخْنُس. You know al-khannas? When he hears, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَ. When he hears the adhan, he leaves with what? Passing wind. When he hears the adhan call, his arrival with Allah, give me a break, man. He's a rival with us. He's after us. He's after us. He want to prove to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we don't deserve that status. That's his mission. قال شوف قال أرأيتك هذا الذي كرمت عليه. شوف. You see the trace that you placed above me? لئن أخرتني إلى يوم القيامة. If you delay me until, if you give me the respite until the day of resurrection, لأحتنكن ذرية. You know أحتنكن? You know أحتنكن? You know, التحنيك. I will eat them with my. شوف الغل. غريب هذا الرجل. غريب. This is weird. I mean, why? We didn't do anything to you, man. What's going on? All right. Let me finish up here. We gotta finish. Okay. So we mentioned why they claim that he is an angel because of what? Come on. Because of what? Being influenced by the people of the book. We're trying to explain why some people disputed the origin of the of Satan not to be a jinni. They say that he's an angel. Reason number one is what? Because of the writing of the people of the book. The second reason is, you see, the story of Adam and Satan were mentioned in the Quran in 7 places. Al-Baqarah, count with me. 2, Al-A'raf, Al-Isra, Taha, Sad. There is what? There is one more. Wal-Kahf, there is one more. Huh? The only place, if you read, anybody who reads these verses, look at this. We commanded the angels to bow down to Adam, and they did, except Satan. He refused, he was arrogant, he disbelieved. So anybody who reads that text, because of istithna, the exception normally must come from the same what? If I say, دَخَلَ النَّاسُ إِلَّا أَحْمَدُ, all people entered except Ahmed. So Ahmed is what? Is people, is a human. دَخَلَ الطُّلَّابُ إِلَّا عَلِي, all the students entered except Ali. So Ali is what? A student. So the exempt is from the nature of what? هذا بيسموه استثناء متصل في اللغة. But see, there is another type which is munqata. But you do not even need to entertain that, because we have a crystal clear text where it says, indeed we commanded the angels to bow down to Adam. They did, except Satan. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ كَانَ مِنَ الْجِنِّ. So he's jinni. You have a text. You don't need to entertain anything. Al-Hasan al-Basri says, لَمْ يَكُنْ إِبْلِيسُ مِنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ طَرْفَةَ عَيْنِ. Iblis was not an angel for a blink of an eye. We're finishing up here quickly. Is Shaytan the father of the jinn? Like Adam is the father of what? Of the human. Is Shaytan the father of the jinn? The answer is what? We don't know. The only text that we have is he is from the jinn. It is somehow encrypted in our minds that Shaytan is a very ugly looking. Shaytan qabih al-surah, very ugly. Very ugly looking. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to let us, شوف الآيات هذه عجيبة في سورة الصفات. اللي هي شجرة الزقوم. You know, there is a tree in paradise. إنا جعلناها فتنة للظالمين. إنها شجرة تخرج في أصل الجحيم. A tree that springs out in fire. A tree that is going to grow in fire. That's why the disbelievers, when they heard the verse, said, what is this? A tree that is going to grow in fire? Yeah. إنا جعلناها فتنة فتنة للظالمين. Huh? Now, look at this. The fruits of that tree looks like the heads of devils. طلعها كأنه. Normally, when you want to bring something closer to the mind, you try to use what? Something that you already know. So you don't know how the fruits are, and you don't know how the heads of devils are. But if I ask you right now, brothers, take 5 minutes, I want you to draw the image of Shaytan in your head. And I'm going to go give a prize to the winner. Guess which one is going to win? The one who comes up with what? The ugliest picture. For that, Christians, you know, Christians in the Middle Ages, you know, Christians when they were, you know, having fun in these dark ages, and we were, mashallah, producing and coming up with algebra, and Muslims are out there leading the world, huh? You know, they said this. They actually depicted Satan, a black man.
I'm sorry to the brothers. Look at these guys, man. These guys are crazy, racist. I'm telling you that. Look at this. So they depicted Satan to be a black man who has a pointed beard. You know that pointed beard? Down? Okay, man. Let me see this. Pointed beard. And his eyebrows are what? You know, eyebrows are raised. And they you know, they up, raised up eyebrows. And his mouth blows fire. Huh? And he has horns, cloven feet, and a tail. That's, you know, so it's ugly. For sure, and this is the last piece that we're going to study today, inshallah. Shaitan has two horns. We believe that actually, that Shaitan has two horns. Fi Sahih Imam Muslim, Hadith Ibn Umar, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us, when the sun rises, wait until it fully rises, and then pray. And when the sun sets, wait until it fully sets, and then pray. Why? Because when it rises and when it rises between the two horns of Shaitan, and it sets between the two horns of Shaitan. And he explained that the people who worship Shaitan, they choose that time to pray. They choose that time to pray to worship Shaitan. But again, Ikhwa, the correct ruling regarding this issue, this only applies to a salah, al-nafila al-mutlaqa. That you just want to pray at this time with no reason. But if you have a reason to pray, you can pray at these times, like tahiyyat al-masjid, like you're making up a nafila, you're making up a salah, you can do this. Insha'Allah, don't miss our next lecture, as we will talk about, their dwelling places, their food. It's going to be more fun, insha'Allah, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والحمد لله رب العالمين. I don't know if you want to have question and answer. I'm open for that. Come on, don't do that. Yeah, there are people who do this. We're going to come to this. Oh, it's going to get more interesting. I'm telling you, just hang in there. But they disbelieve, so they become disbelievers. Oh, yeah. No, they are not. Have fun. Now. Who?
فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.